Hello, Andrew here. The other day we had something happen here for the very first time, which has never really happened before. We were hacked. The house was hacked. I was minding my own business. I was actually with a client, and you know, if you ever had it where sometimes the mouse might move just like a fraction, and you think to yourself, how did that do that? Now, with the optical mice that I use, mouses, sometimes if it hits a particle of dust or what have you, it creates like an erroneous command on the computer, and sometimes the cursor may slowly scroll down to the bottom of the screen or up to the top of the screen and then stop because it runs out of screen space. Well, I'm sat there with my friend slash client trying to show him the latest in how to take care of all of his social networks in one fell swoop. When I'm sat down to Dee's brand new computer downstairs, a brand new 27-inch iMac, lovely machine, and then with a few issues, but then her older G5... power PC. It's a quad core. No, actually, she's got a new system. That was a new system with the Intel Xeon processors. Also from a friend slash clients. A lot of my clients turn into friends. That system was off to the side, and that's hooked up to a 30-inch monitor. Well, at the corner of my eye, I see the cursor go boop, and I look at this. I look at the cursor, and instantly I thought to myself, that almost looked and felt like it was a test move of the cursor to see if anyone was this end watching. So then I saw it go boop, and it stopped again. And that kind of reaffirmed what I was thinking. So then my brain was going, you know, like a million miles an hour, like who has access into this, into the house? Really confused at that point. As many of you know, I'm an ex Apple technician, and being on the road and out and about, it's nice to have access to my files whenever I need them. So I went into the router settings years ago, and I opened up a port. It was port 5900, which is technically on the router. It was in the port forwarding section. So any call from the outside world into our home. And what you have to understand is a few things had to be in place here, and whoever it was needed to know a few bits of pertinent information. Now stay tuned to the end, because I'm going to tell you the result of all of this. I call the police and everything. So what happens is I see the mouse move, then I don't really look to see what windows are open on that particular computer, because a lot of the time there's a lot of windows open, and I see a window close. I'm like, crap, what did they just close? In actual fact, to be honest, that didn't kick in for a little bit. I just thought someone was trying to access the computer. What works in our favor is that hard drive that on that particular computer is dying. So they may be trying to do a command, or they may tell the window to close, but it actually takes the beach ball spins, and then it takes a little while because the hard drive is dying. But it does it, just a slower pace. So what they were doing was opening up, looking for and opening up sensitive documents and doing a screenshot. So they got all of these credit card information, all of her passwords, all of her account info, usernames and passwords for everything. I told Dee a couple of years ago to not have her passwords and account info in a little handy document saying passwords and account info. She did. She had two of these on desktop. And to be honest, I had not really thought too much about it because it wasn't on my system. It's just every time I went on her computer, I saw these files and I was like, shouldn't be on here. These shouldn't be on here. So long story short, later that day, Dee discovers a purchase on her Amazon account, Amazon Prime. We called Amazon immediately because she got notified by email. I then called her credit card company and Amazon. Amazon said, thank you so much. They went and tried to contact the person. It's amazing that they don't have like one click cancel, you know, that it just puts a freeze on the whole thing. They then had to go trying to chase down the original seller of this laptop, this $850 laptop, which was being sent to an address in New York City. So I think to myself, we can catch ourselves a thief. And I almost wanted to turn it into a video to show you. So I look on Google Maps, I find the address, and then I find the nearest police station, which was the 105th precinct, to the drop-off point. And I said to one of the detectives, I said, look, not sure if you want to catch a thief. I said, but our credit card information got stolen today. Someone bought a laptop and it's being delivered tomorrow near you. And then they said, well, sorry, Mr. Jones, but that's not typically how it works. The thieves cover their tracks. So yes, they stole your information. Yes, they purchased a laptop. Yes, it'll be delivered tomorrow in New York City. But if you look to see where that is, it's an international shipping company. The international shipping company is a guilt-free, kind of hassle-free vendor that will send your products all over the world. They are not the thieves, supposedly. They then send it to Nigeria, Africa, wherever it might be. I mean, first things first, why don't we have a block on shipping stuff to some countries like that to go through an extra layer of, you know, did this person buy stuff? Is this a legit purchase? You know, what have you. I know, too many logistics for it to be reality right now. So, yeah, I called the police. He said, what you would need to do is your girlfriend would need to go to the local police, file a report, and then they would contact us, and then maybe we'll follow up. But more than likely, we won't have anything to go on. Just an amazing, like, it would never happen to me, you know? I'm a Mac tech still. Although I'm not certified still.
Yeah.
Just to see the cursor on that screen move all by itself, to see windows open and close, and I didn't pay attention as to what was happening. While my client was here, he saw it happen as well, some of it. And so I spent the rest of that day changing usernames, passwords, account numbers, cancelling credit cards, getting new credit cards. I did a search for the social security number on her Mac. So here's my thoughts for you. Think like a thief. Sit down at your laptop, think like a thief, and do a search for the types of information that you would want to find if you were on someone else's Mac. So, for example, having been a Mac technician for so many years, when I sit down on a personal computer, I often find the most incriminating evidence, if you were to call it that, in a file called, for example, to be filed, or file this. Sometimes it's blatant, like, you know, personal info, private data, and what have you. But look through your computer. Search for the words credit card, Search for the words credit. Search for the words account. Search for the words password, username. Search for all the stuff that if someone was to access your computer, this would be a very root, very basic level of going through someone's computer. That's just the tip of the iceberg. But if you can get rid of these particular files or secure them with programs, you're going to be way ahead of the game. A fantastic program on the Macintosh. I have all that information on my computer, but there's two great programs that I use. One is Evernote. That's one very good program. It's kind of touted for its ability to safely store. Nothing is safe, right? Let's get that straight, especially from the NSA. Excuse me. But for the average person on the street trying to get in to get your data, your info, they're not at least going to be able to find it. The other application is called Vault. Now, Vault, V-A-U-L-T, is specifically for Mac, I believe. You could search for it on PC, but it's definitely for Mac. And a great little app. It creates a locked folder, an encrypted folder. You can create them in various sizes. You put stuff in. You have to have a password to open it. When you leave your computer, always make sure that you eject that folder, and you'll be good to go. They won't be able to access it. But like I said, anything, even if you type or if you talk around a smart device these days, someone said to me on the Facebook page that, well, I just don't keep any of that information on my computer, hence they'll never get that from me. Well, that's not true. If you have a smartphone, if you have a smart device, if you have a tablet, if you have a computer with a microphone attached, even today they showed a video where you do not need a microphone on your device any longer for people to be able to take the images or the video feed from the video feed, and they can decipher sounds by the minuscule vibrational changes in the environment around you. So for example, this t-shirt, for example, this chair I'm sitting on, or the green screen, anything that's visible, even the hair on my head, their software that can zoom in, it can look at the minuscule, and I'm talking 1/100th of a pixel in vibration. They could, just like it's like reverse of how a speaker works. A speaker vibrates and it creates a sound. Well, in this way, the sound makes everything in this room vibrate, which is how you can listen through a glass, because it kind of amplifies the vibration. So I just took a shower. I got water in my ear. So secure yourself. Look for the stuff that's on your computer that's easy to be found. Secure it. Use applications like Vault or Evernote. It will work on all your devices, and securely carry your stuff around with you. So that's it. Just a scary situation. Still waiting to see any repercussions, really, of further things that might have happened since. But never thought it would happen to me, you know? Just incredible. Or happen to us. But that was a port. Here's the other aspect. Here's the port that was open on the computer. It was port 5900. There's other ports that can also be open for people to have access to your network. So what you need to do is go into your router settings. Typically for many routers, that would be something like, if you go into a web browser, open up a web browser, Firefox, Chrome, Safari, etc. And in the web address, type 192.168.1.1. That won't work for everyone, but that will work for many people. A two-section window will open for username and password. Try admin and then leave the other one blank. Try admin, admin. Try admin for username and try password for the password field. But if you know your settings, great. Then go to port forwarding is one of the areas you want to look at, and see if 5900 is set up. See if it's open. If you've had a tech service come out and support you so that they can work on your systems while you know they can take over your computer, sometimes, more often than not, in yesteryear, that port would have to be open. So they would leave open port 5900, and they still need a couple of things. First, hackers need to know your household IP address. That's simple. People can find that from any email that you send them from home. So, you know, the first part of me being able to hack you, or a thief being able to hack you, is knowing your IP address. If you go to whatismyip.org, I think, your IP is right there. It will tell you what your IP address. You don't really need to know that. So first of all, opening emails that are spam or phishing emails. They're trying to get information from you. So now they got your IP address. They put that in your folder. They now know, they scan that IP address to see if any ports are open. So now the router will send information back to the hacker to say, hey, for example, one of the ports, 5900, is open. Now, all they need is your password for certain applications. Chicken of the VNC used to be a fantastic one of mine. When I first saw this happening on my computer, I thought it was my old boss, because this is the type of thing that he would do to his clients. He would watch them work, and he would mess with their mouse. Just some very cruel stuff. And he actually got taken to court for it at one point. Related stuff. But if people only knew the extent of what I know. But anyway. Karma has an amazing way of taking care of things that need to be taken care of. So I trust in that. So, yeah, I thought it was my old boss. So then I was going to go pay them a visit, because it just felt like him. And I was going to go pay him a visit and lay down a very sturdy warning. But then the credit card purchase, and then I didn't think he'd go that far. So I kind of knew that it wasn't him at that point. So I went into the router log. When you're in the router, if you go to the section that says log, it will show you all the attempts for your computer reaching out into the world. Well, guess what I found? Hundreds and hundreds of attempts from midnight the previous night all the way to this morning, the morning that this happened, from like Uganda, Nigeria, Australia, the UK, everyone trying to come in on port 5900 to our house. So there was hundreds of people all over the world trying to access our house to get information. And they were successful. They were not successful, though, in getting the product. Amazon was able to put a stop on the delivery of the laptop to the international shipping company. Wow. And I got another story as well to tell you, but I'm just going to leave this as its own video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Got some fantastic stuff coming up, and I really hope you're around to see what's happening and see what's new. Okay, speak to you soon. Bye.